So I'm going to compare two kind of an interesting type of artifact and art, Roman and Han Dynasty funerary urns. So those are urns that have been used to hold the ashes of those who were dead and cremated. And this is a Roman urn right here. And what strikes me first when I look at this, and I'm going to try hard not to make generalizations about all Roman urns, but in this particular case, the urn is very, it's very simple. It serves a purpose. It tells us some information. It holds ashes. So the purpose that it serves, it tells us the name, which is going to be this here, Celia Epire. It tells us where, from the Sacred Way, which is a street leading through Rome. And it tells us what this person was. She was an Aroestrix, which is a gold cloth maker. So she perhaps embroidered gold onto clothing. And then it tells us about her husband, of course, down here in large font. Quintius Fugius Olympicus, who his name here is telling us that this is the property or the product of that Quintus. So I see something that's straightforward, direct, unadorned. That compares with what I see in the Han Dynasty urn. So in the Han Dynasty urn, which is going to be called a Hu, I see something much, much more decorative. There's flowing form here, which kind of matches the flowing imagery that I see in here. According to the website of the Metropolitan Museum of Art, that this is decorated with a drama of a blue beast with fangs lunging at a mounted armor, at a mounted archer. So I can only assume that this here is our archer, although it could be the beast. I honestly have a hard time discerning what's going on here without a picture of the reverse side, which I could not find. I see something that's much more decorative. There's detail up here in the top. There's detail around the sides. All of this area in the middle. There's a lot of action going on. This is something that you see in decorative Greco-Roman pottery, but it's not something you saw in that funerary urn before. So that's a point of contrast that I see. I also see a point of similarity that they're both, although this one is perhaps more flowy, they're both practical vessels. They serve a purpose. They hold things. This is art for a practical purpose here. And we can see that when we compare them side by side, we see that, well, you know, they're both functional in some aspect. Well, this might be classified as art today, especially the Han Dynasty Hu. They both serve this purpose. They're both earthenware, so they're the same medium, clay. But it's interesting to contrast this, what seems like a different purpose to this urn. With the Roman urn, it's really telling you about the person inside. Whereas with the Han Dynasty Chinese urn, it seems to be telling us more of this story about what's going on with a fanged beast and the mounted archer, perhaps telling us something about who is inside, but more likely suggests the Met Museum is telling us something about the character of the person inside, what sort of values they had when they were alive. So I think that's an interesting distinction to draw. And although these are by no means representative samples of the urns as a whole from either group, it's interesting to see them side by side. So that concludes my analysis of these two.